What's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. We're heading back out to Chinaman's Gulch. I did not think we would be going back so soon. If you remember from my last video, I struggled quite a bit in my Forerunner, especially in the snow. So my whole goal was to hopefully have a front locker put on before I attempted it again, but I have yet to do that. Now, if you've been watching my Instagram stories, I've been hinting at a new rig that my brother is working on and hoping to be wheeling that this summer. Now, unfortunately, things did not go as planned when we got to Chinaman's Gulch. A little backstory, I had texted my brother 1 week before the run and was like, yo, do you think we can get the 91 ready for the New Year's Day hangover run? And he's like, really? 1 week's notice? That's all you're gonna give me? Remind you, this truck has been sitting for 6 years. Yes, 6 years. He's like, I'll see what I can do. To my surprise, the stars aligned and everything kind of fell into place and everything was working great up until we got there. I was so excited. I haven't wheeled anything like this before, so I was gonna be mostly riding passenger. I figured if I got confident with the dual transfer cases and kind of understood everything, I figured I might give it a shot and hopefully get some seat time under my belt before summer. We got there and the drive shaft slipped out. Pretty embarrassing pulling up into the parking lot with, you know, 30 plus rigs and the drive shaft isn't even in the truck. So thankfully we're surrounded by so many awesome people in this community, and we had a couple dudes come up to us and help us out right away and see what we can get going before we started the trail run. Put the drive shaft obviously back in, shortened some links, and that was it. For a reason, the links did not want to move. I want to say the driver's side was shortening, but for whatever reason, the passenger was not, and so it ended up being kind of an ordeal. We finally got it off the trailer and there was like no power. It was sluggish. So I don't know if maybe there's a fuel pump issue, but at that point it was already like 10:30. Everybody was going to be starting the trail around 9:30, and I looked at my brother and I said, you know what? Fuck it. There's plenty of people we can ride passenger with. So that's what we ended up doing. We hopped in some friends' trucks and went along for an awesome day. This video is gonna show you some really cool trucks, from buggies to rock crawlers to daily drivers, all sorts of different builds. We got Jeeps, we got FJs, we got Tacomas, we got 4Runners. I think I saw a Ford Ranger out there. It's pretty badass. So many awesome builds. Despite how the day started, it ended up being a really fun wheeling trip. So shout out to Lauren at KREYZFAB for putting this all together. If you do not follow him, you need to. He's a badass. He's an amazing fabricator. He's the one that did my rear bumper, and his rig is top notch. So if you like to see cool shit that's being built on some rock crawlers, definitely follow his page. I'll tag him on here. And so here we go. All right, so we are over here at my brother's house. We are getting ready to load up the 91 back here, and I'm excited to show you some fun wheeling tomorrow. All right, so she's off the trailer, but unfortunately, she is gonna be staying here. We'll just be riding with passenger with somebody. Oh well.
Passenger a little. Now driver.
It slipped. I made the wrong angle.
Stop. Rear diff.
Yeah.
Stay just like that.
Huh?
Stay just like that.
Is he on ground?
Yeah, right there. Now cut back, passenger.
Halfway counts.
Yeah, no, I was.
These should stick. What? These tires are crap.
I believe in those tires. See, it's got
you're
it.
In the
got
four- it. It's you're got in the fourth gen, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
It's got it. I believe in those.
Now we're going to be coming up to one of the major obstacles on Chinaman's, which is Whale's Tail. Now, in my last video, we all took the far right line because it seems to be usually the easiest line out of the three. We also have totally different vehicles than what you're seeing in the clip. Some of these guys are going to be attempting the harder lines, and they're still gonna struggle because it is so slick out there, but it's awesome watching some of them attempt it and even make it up. So I'm just in awe.
Thank you.
crazy wheeling with all these guys and realizing how small 37s look. I'm like, I know. Like, holy shit.
Yeah, this is gonna be a struggle. Shit.
Yeah. Lost your purse!
hold on.
You lost your purse!
Stay passenger.
Ben's truck, uh-huh. and he'd go around the corner. Because uh-huh. they were so bad, the whole cab would fucking move.
Jeez.
Like,
dang.
6 inches every corner. Which Ben? My old friend Ben was off. That's such a pretty view. I was just sitting here just looking at
this. Yeah. I was just chilling.
You know, and I can't see over my fucking hood yet again, so we're just gonna kind of eyeball it. Hope there's not a drop off. This is why I like having cats. They can check my blind spots. Yeah, you should have gone higher. There's not even that much snow today.
No, this is dry compared to.
Can I get my body in? Can I even get it to hit the rung? Oh yeah, I can. Boo! It just hit the tire.
All right, so we just got back from finishing Chinaman's. We got the pickup loaded back up. Unfortunately, she made it off the trailer, but not onto the trail. So we ended up just riding passenger with a few people, and it was a good time. I didn't really jump on here a whole lot to narrate. To be honest, I just wanted to record some cool rigs, doing some cool shit, and I think we got a few good clips. So we're nearing the end of the video, but I have to jump on here real quick and add this little clip. We had finished the trail run and we were pretty exhausted, so my brother and I started to load up the 91. Well, Jonathan and Nate decided to go for a little joyride up Carnage Canyon. Now, if you're familiar with Carnage, it is a buggy trail. I mean, it's one of the hardest trails in Colorado. Pretty freaking gnarly. And these two guys decided to go up the gatekeeper, and unfortunately Jonathan did blow his rear diff. I wasn't up there, so I didn't see anything and didn't have any video, but I do kind of have the aftermath of some of the guys helping him down, and pretty unfortunate for him.
We got enough there.
Alright guys, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. It truly means a lot to me. This has been a huge learning curve, and especially as a busy mama, I want to try to push myself this year and get out of my comfort zone. So by you guys commenting and liking, it's going to keep me going and making these videos for you all. So again, I really appreciate it, and we will see you next time. Waiting the whole time. Oh gosh. So anyways, let's change the detent ball. We struggled, and it makes me feel a little. And this is what happens when you fuck around and find out the